it's a lovely tranquil morning here at Farringdon Station, where the works for the platforms minus 6 levels down below are taking place. People are just walking past without even realising that it's going on. We're going to go in and have a look at the exits. This is just one of many open days that Crossrail / TfL Elizabeth Line are doing as they preview all the stations. And for me, the most exciting part has been previously at Custom House and Canary Wharf, they gave away Oyster wallets. Now, it's the World Cup at the moment, and I'm thinking if I'm gonna collect all 10 Oyster wallets, it's a bit like when people used to collect Panini football stickers for the World Cup. So instead of collecting Russia 2018 World Cup stickers, I'm gonna be collecting all the Oyster wallets. Yeah. I'm very excited because I can see on this table down here the thing that I really came for. And I'm pleased to say there's a whole table of Oyster wallets. That's all I'm here for. How many can I have?
As many as you like. Two for a start.
Two. What's your name?
Nigel.
Nigel, my worry is that as the railway gets handed over to TfL, will TfL keep producing Oyster wallets, or is this a Crossrail thing only?
The moment this is just a Crossrail thing, but what TfL do...
But if I don't complete the set of Oyster wallets, this is really going to like upset me.
It's going to cause you a lot of pain, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really to complete the set.
Well, have a word with Adam and he'll make sure that he'll give you all the ones that you need.
I've said that on camera.
Yeah.
Okay, right. Onto the platform. So, I can see some platform edge doors here, and I can see a purple roundel there. Morning. We're in a concourse between, we're at the western end, there are some escalators there, but interestingly, there's a lot of purple. And here's another thing, someone said this the other day, they sent a picture of it to me. They went, did you realise, Geoff, the platforms at Custom House are A and B, are they all going to be lettered? I can tell you now, we've just had it confirmed, that on the 9 core stations in the middle, so from Paddington down to, is it Woolwich? Yeah. The eastbound platforms on all the Crossrail Elizabeth Line stations are going to be platform A, and the westbound platforms are all going to be lettered platform B, so they're all letters. And a lot of purple. Here's 20 seconds of purple signage. I like the purple. They're laughing at me. What? I like the purple colour. It's my favourite thing about...
Please stop touching.
Sorry.
Fingerprints.
What? We have to clean it if I get it dirty.
Fingerprint. I will, I'll be there brushing it off.
Just seen here, so for platform B, the westbound platform, they've already put in on the map that it's going to Terminal 5. Now don't forget that the line opens in stages, and they're going to have to put some sticker over that, because when it opens in December 2018, trains aren't going to be running through to Terminal 5, so expect this to be blocked over until December 2019, and then the line will be running to Terminal 5. But they've obviously put it in so they don't have to put the sign in twice, but expect there to be like a little sticker there. On the westbound platform, eastbound platform, that's platform A, trains going that way. There's a legible London poster. It says here, Farringdon exit, Barbican exit. And I can show you here that the Farringdon exit is within Farringdon station, and the Barbican exit over here, it's on the corner, got to get this right, of Long Lane and Lindsay Street, one way in, one way out at the eastern end, and the other one is on the corner of Haynes Street. And there's also then the lift to Barbican, but basically it's here at the eastern end, and it's here at the western end. I feel like we should go and have a look and see where the exits are in real life. Okay, I'm in the Farringdon end, the western end. Bear with me, this is slightly confusing. We'll try and get our orientation here. There was a shot, here it is again, of some escalators down at the western end of the Elizabeth line. These here are the tops of those escalators. They come through to here, and then you're into the main ticket hall here. Now, let me just make sure I've got my shot here. These escalators here then go up, and that goes to the main, what they call the integrated ticket office, which is the National Rail, the existing ticket office and gate line for Farringdon National Rail Station. And you'll come in, and there's a wall up there, and then you come down them escalators. But then off to this side, that then goes through to platform 4, at Farringdon, just making sure I got that right. Yes, I have. And that is the Thames Link. That takes you, platform 4 is the northbound Thames Link platform here at Farringdon Station. Got that? Do you remember Andy? You probably don't. He had a beard back then. Did you have a beard?
I did have a beard.
Andy showed, was the man to show me about the incline lift when I came here before. Andy's back. What happened to the beard?
Beard's gone. Beard's gone.
Were they shaved off by the diamonds?
Well, the diamonds, see, we've got them all in now.
Why are you so excited by the diamonds?
Well, diamonds, just look at them. This is Simon Puritan's artwork that's come in. Once they're backlit, they'll be beautiful. So you've got these and the ceiling as well, because it all ties in together.
So this is the artwork at the West End ticket office here. But for those that haven't made the correlation, could you explain the correlation about diamonds at Farringdon?
See, diamonds, we've got Hatton Gardens across the road. That actually links in with the station within the community. So for here, when you want to come out at Farringdon End, look for diamonds.
Think diamonds. What's at the eastern end?
If you look at the east, you've got a coffered ceiling. So then you're at the Barbican end. And if you then want to be at the other end where you see diamonds, you've got then half a kilometre to walk, or you come out at the lift.
So this is the layout of the new Farringdon station. The new platform is having the main entrance at the western end, which link up with the Thames Link and the Tube, and the eastern end of the platforms exiting to street level and a lift up to the westbound platform of Barbican Tube Station as well. Changing between the new platforms and the Tube at Farringdon will involve going via the Thames Link platforms, or, as has even been suggested, it might be quicker to exit Farringdon at the National Rail gate line, cross the street and re-enter Farringdon Station at the Tube gate line. We'll only find out for sure what's quicker when it opens. So we're back outside. I think Andy's meant to be working, but I've just said to him, Andy, come with me. So Andy's come with me. Thanks, Andy. So we're at the main National Rail Station. They call this the Integrated Ticket Office, is that correct?
Integrated Ticket Hall, yes.
Integrated Ticket Hall. So this is the wall here. We were the other side of that wall, but
yes.
But the interesting news that you've just told me, you've got to face the camera.
Sorry.
Is that they're actually going to extend the gate line, is that correct?
So yes.
This gate line here is going to be extended further, right?
Yes, you get the gate line extended out, and then there's a balcony, a glazed balcony, so you actually look out over the diamond ceiling and up down to the ticket hall and up down to where you then go around and then down the escalators to the Elizabeth line.
Can you show me the other entrance, the Barbican eastern end? Can you lead the way?
Yes, lead the way.
Let's do a speed it up section. Where are we?
This is Grand Avenue, Smithfield Market.
Yes, so we're in Smithfield. So we're cutting through Smithfield.
Come through Grand Avenue.
So the platforms are beneath us right now?
Yes.
So when you're in Smithfield Market, the smell. I don't know why I've not been here sooner. Off camera, Annie went, this is my baby that I've spent 4.5 years digging. This is it. Okay, I'm going to turn around so you can see it like this. So we're on, so it's in between, name the two streets again. So that's
Haynes Street,
and
this is Lindsay Street.
And it's basically taking up a little block, as it were. London doesn't really do like blocks like the Americans just do, but here, abandoned, there is an effect like a little block which you've taken over,
yeah.
And that's where the ticket hall is. What can you tell us about the ticket hall?
So the ticket hall, we've got all the glazing up now. So it's a two-story basement at this side, seven-story shaft at the other side that we excavated down to, and then we've built all the way up from the bottom, built up to +3 in order to get all the ventilation in, and then we're putting the finishes in. You can just see the gate, the barcode Farringdon gate over there, and then we've got all the glazing in. Glazing then links us into the market. So if you look at the wrought iron around the market windows, that's what's represented in the glazing that goes around the ticket hall.
And then how far away is Barbican Tube Station? That's just another, 30 seconds walk down there. But use the western end. This is the important thing. People want to know which end of the train to get out at. So the Farringdon entrance is at the western end.
Yes.
This is the eastern end. And you'd use this if you were more wanting the Barbican slash Smithfield Market end.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
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 Yes, Geoff. Yes.
So, turn around. So, I've come to Barbican Tube on the westbound subsurface platform. You can see here the blue hoardings, the telltale blue hoardings, which means one thing. Yeah, this is the lift. This is going to be the other way in and out of Farringdon Crossrail station. So at the eastern end, what happens if you're at the eastern end of a Crossrail Elizabeth Line train, you'll come up escalators or an incline lift. You'll go from -6 to -3, like a mezzanine -3 level. And there you'll see some artwork, which isn't the diamonds. So what Andy was saying to me is that if you don't see the diamonds, you know you're not at the western end. So at that point, you've got a choice, if you're at the wrong end, to turn around and go back or keep on going. From that -3 level, there's then other escalators and another incline lift, which then take you up to that ticket hall, which we just saw, or at that point there's a sneaky little corridor which will bring you down to a lift, a regular lift, not an incline lift, a regular lift, which will bring you out here to the westbound platform at Barbican Station. So if you find that you wanted to be at the western end, at the Farringdon end, and you came out the wrong exit by mistake, hilariously, here's what you can do. You could be on a Crossrail Elizabeth Line train, come through to Farringdon Station, exit out the eastern end, come up here to Barbican Tube, and then do what I'm about to do, and that's get the tube one stop west back to Farringdon. Is it quicker to walk, or is it quicker to get the tube one stop to be maybe back at the entrance exit that you wanted to be at? This is the thing with the Crossrail Elizabeth Line. The trains are really long. Do not be at the wrong end. It's my train.